was a superb highlight at this year's Oscars.
She encouraged her kids to be creative, to work hard. That girl is my mother, and she's here tonight.
Jared Leto winning Best Supporting Actor for his role in the film Dallas Buyers Club in a speech that brought the house down.
To those of you out there who have ever felt injustice because of who you are or who you love, tonight I stand here in front of the world with you and for you. Thank you so much and good night.
A highlight of a career that has seen him star in over 20 films. But Jared doesn't just act. As frontman for 30 Seconds to Mars, the band has released four critically acclaimed albums, and their last tour saw them play 311 shows on six continents to 3 million people. And after visiting us last year for a quick stop...
I'm going to be weird, but you're a really good-looking guy. Oh, wow, yeah, here we go. I'm glad I'm sitting at a desk.
The band are in the country to rock your socks off.
Welcome back, Academy Award winner Jared Leto.
I was worried you wouldn't remember me.
Gotta start things out right. It's not a happy ending, it's a happy beginning.
We'll see about that. You don't know what's going on there. Anyway.
It's really funny again.
Am I blushing? I could be. I've tried to keep in touch, but you haven't given me your email address, so I have a lot of draft emails.
They warned me about you.
They warned you.
Last time I was here, Twitter exploded. You know, it was insane. The reaction to this show was amazing, and it was really fun. So thanks for having me back. I really appreciate it.
What are you talking about?
This little nonsense. Wow. Goodness me. Seriously, though, congratulations on the Oscar.
Thank you.
That's a massive deal. And congratulations on owning the moment. It was beautiful. Have you come back down to earth from all that yet?
You don't ever really want to come back down to earth. And really, the prize that you get isn't a statue. It's not a pat on the back. It's the opportunity to stand in front of the world and to say something to the people that mean so much to you. So it was nice. I'm glad that my brain was working and that I was able to kind of just spit out the words that I wanted to.
It was certainly work. I mean, I know you've been told probably this over and over again, but the moment where you talked about your mum was just so beautiful. If people didn't love you enough, they just then went, oh, my God. I mean, was she expecting that? Did she have any idea?
No, she didn't have any idea. I didn't let anybody kind of in on what I wanted to say, but I knew I wanted to say something about my mother, about my brother, who shared this journey of 30 Seconds to Mars with me for so long, and I wanted to say something about injustice, about AIDS. So, you know, you can use that moment to kind of absorb the light that's shining your direction or reflect it back towards other things, and that's what I did.
Most people, because you're an actor, would think that would be an easy thing to do, but, I mean, how different is that, giving a speech like that, compared to, you know, performing?
Well, I think because I'm a musician, it actually made it a little bit easier because I'm on a stage most nights of the week. As an actor, you're kind of protected. You don't really interact with people in that way unless you're a theater actor or something, but even that, you know, it's a very unique experience, one that makes your brain turn to mush, and you know, I'm just glad that I was able to think a little bit while I was up there.
When you're acting or when you're making a speech in front of an audience, you get an immediate reaction, but in your many films, including Dallas Buyers Club, do you know there's no audience, do you know immediately that you've nailed the role?
I think that you can feel the truth when it hits you. And, you know, that's the search when you're an actor. It's easy to tell a lie. It's difficult to tell the truth. And in a film like Dallas Buyers Club, it's all about the truth. It's such a beautiful and challenging story. You want to do justice to these characters and to the circumstances.
The speech that you made, which the movie drew attention to the plight of HIV sufferers, and you encapsulated the moment well, it actually reminded me, I don't know if you remember, I think it was 73... Marlon Brando actually refused an Oscar and sent a Native American to refuse the Oscar on his behalf to make a statement.
Yeah.
Did you actually feel when you were giving that speech that you were perhaps doing something that would be remembered longer and say more than perhaps people thanking their agent a lot?
Well, I didn't know. You know, that's it. That's, I mean, like I said before, you have an opportunity, right? That 2 minutes that you get to stand on that stage and speak to the world, that's one of the greatest gifts I've ever gotten in my lifetime. And I had no expectation. I just knew that I wanted to say what was important to me and I hoped important to other people. But certainly the speech transcended even the Oscar, the response. And, you know, it's a lesson about the power of words. Not only the good things, but interestingly enough, in Russia, they censored the Oscars. They yanked it off the air because of what I said about the Ukraine. We went to the Ukraine 3 days later to play a show that was scheduled, and then to Russia. So it started this whole kind of really unique series of experiences.
One thing they can't censor in the Ukraine or anywhere is the internet. And you were in Ellen's most retweeted selfie.
Yeah.
Have we got a
barely?
Yeah, barely.
That's my eyeball. That is my eyeball.
You really should have taken. That's your eyeball. Did you think about taking Meryl out at any point?
I when that happened, this is a true story, I didn't know it was going to happen, but I think that most of the people in that picture were kind of privy to the selfie. But I thought it was a spontaneous moment, duh. And I literally got up out of my chair, which was on the opposite side of the theater, and I said, I got to get in on this. And I ran over.
But did you just go and party hard? Like, how good was the after party?
It was
Did
a
you
late
take your
night.
Mom with you?
Yeah, yeah. My mom at some point was dancing with Madonna at an after party.
Oh, doing
Bravo.
Yeah.
How do you dance with Madonna? Do you do the Vogue moves or is it still just that one? Is it that?
Well, you know, it's a crazy night because you see everyone that you see all of these people, these incredibly talented, incredibly famous people, and whether it's, you know, Angelica Houston or Jane Fonda or Meryl Streep, Robert Redford, Al Pacino, you end up meeting these heroes. So it's a really cool thing to be able to look them in the eye and say thanks for the inspiration, and to hear back from them. Like Harrison Ford came up to me and was very complimentary, and it just blows your mind. It's a really nice thing.
We do have to take a very quick break with us on the project.
Now, you kicked off your tour in Perth last night. How'd that go?
Incredible. It was so great. I mean, the best part about Australia is the people. So passionate, such great music lovers. We had an incredible show, and we're looking forward to tomorrow. Where are we playing? I forget the name. Thank you. Yeah, I know what city. I know what city we're in.
Hyacinth Arena, there you go.
I read you said that you're single and that you're happy for Aussie women to come up and introduce themselves.
Don't tell these girls that. They might storm the stairs.
Where exactly are you staying? Your room and your hotel? No, actually, Pete asked me to ask that question.
You play that, well, you probably don't play that game. And when you play that game at your dinner party, what would I rather be, like a massive rock star or a massive movie star? What's better? Which is better?
You know, the nice thing is I don't have to choose. I can kind of do them both. And, you know, it's been the joy of a lifetime to be able to share this with my brother, 30 Seconds to Mars. And what are you giggling at? they're showing a dirty video, I suppose. There are some parts in that you may want to look at if you're broadcasting. So anyway, it's all good. And you know, touring the world is one of the greatest things I could ever imagine doing.
Well, we just feel so lucky that you can spend some time with us tonight. We appreciate